In 1977, Alec Guinness, Obi-Wan Kenobi, spoke to Luke Skywalker about the Clone Wars. And today we're going to talk about the 2002 Attack of the Clones. See you on the other side. Thank you for joining me on Showtime, and today we're going to talk about Attack of the Clones, the 2002 George Lucas movie. Now, I was always curious about these clones. When I heard for the first time Alec Guinness say those words to Luke Skywalker about, and he mentioned about the Clone Wars in The New Hope, in the 1977 movie, I was always so curious about these clones. Who were they? And finally, it arrived in 2002, the epic movie that I was waiting for, the second episode. So this movie was written and directed by George Lucas. And recently, George Lucas was saying that in an article that he sold the rights to Star Wars to Disney because he was fed up of the feedback, the negative feedback that he received on the prequel movies. Well, I believe, as I've just started this channel and I need positive feedback, and I stress on positive feedback, you cannot make a movie just on special effects. And you can see the special effects don't even hold up today. They look terrible, absolutely terrible. The previous trilogy, using practical effects, the effects look still good today. And George Lucas said that it was an experiment. So what? Jar Jar Binks was an experiment? I think it was an experiment gone wrong. I'm sure the actor Ahmed Best will be remembered for Jar Jar Binks, but for me, I will remember it as a complete, utter, useless character that wasn't needed at all to propel the story ahead. But anyway, I was so excited when the trailers came out, and I saw this movie in Italian. Because I live in the Italian part of Switzerland. And I was excited because also Samuel Jackson was joining the cast with his purple lightsaber. So I was like, wow, Samuel Jackson, he has this energy around him, and I really like his acting when he's not shouting and cursing all the time. But it was exciting to have him in there. And also Christopher Lee, who I've seen many of these movies from way back in the 80s, the horror movies, the Hammer movies. And he was playing Count Dooku. And it was great. It was great to see that George Lucas brought these new elements, and also trusting these characters to be acted by these very talented actors and actresses. And also we see Anakin all grown up, Hayden Christensen, and that was taking it in a different way. But a lot of people give him a lot of stick. It's not his fault. It was the way that the movie was written. A lot of people seem to focus on the actor. It's the actor's fault. I don't think it's true. It depends on what script you're given. And obviously, looking back on the trilogy, on the prequel trilogy, it's not his fault. It's the way it was written. You can just look at, it's just all special effects, and it's lacking in storyline. And the chemistry between Padme played by Natalie Portman. They're gonna remember all these names. So there was no chemistry there. I just wasn't feeling it. Also, I liked in this movie the epic battle between Jango Fett and Obi-Wan Kenobi. Wow, it's just still breathtaking. I saw this movie a few weeks ago, and I gotta say, yes, in that instant, the effects still look good. But for me, it was just the whole excitement to see Obi-Wan Kenobi fight Jango Fett. Amazing. I still love it. And also towards the end of the movie, with all the Jedi Knights, I remember the trailer, and you see all these Jedi Knights running forward. This was epic. This is what I was waiting for. But George, come on. It could have been done so much better. So much better. And also seeing the subplot of the clone army and how they're manufactured. This was good, but it was just too many plot holes. More George, he's such a good writer, so talented, and he wrote the original trilogy. So of course I was expecting something better. It's like if you have someone that always gives you an A plus every time, and then they start giving you a D minuses and Fs, you're left a little bit sad, a little bit, you just can't understand. Nobody knows Star Wars better than George Lucas. He's the master, he knows everything. So you would think that the prequels would have been better than what we were given. So on that aspect of Attack of the Clones, this 2002 movie, I'm gonna rate this movie with a 5. With a 5. It could have been so much better. It really was, because the build-up was there, the setup was there, but it was just a big letdown. So a 5. And I really love Star Wars. If you see my Facebook page, it's just Star Wars. I've loved Star Wars forever. And 5 is a very low rating, but I'm giving it a 5 because the lack of the story. A special effects movie or sci-fi movie just can't be just about special effects. You've got to have some chemistry. You've got to have a great script, and this movie was lacking that. It's in so many ways, and I don't want to criticize anyone too much because I've never directed a movie. I've never written a script for a big budget epic movie. So I don't want to judge too much there, because people like to judge too much and they've never actually been in that person's shoes. But looking at the movie, looking at this franchise, I've got to give it a 5. So thank you guys for tuning in. I'm up to Jessica Jones episode number 10. So as soon as I finish watching the last few episodes, I will definitely do a review. I love Jessica Jones. And see you very soon on Showtime. And let's talk about movies. Take care. And if you like this move, if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to Showtime, and see you very, very soon. Bye-bye.